Still got to keep an eye on household expenditure. Which isn't to say we couldn't get some nice taxidermy animals, bring a touch of gentility to the place. You know, a boar's head or two. Mr. T, you listening to me?
Of course.
And what did I just say?
There must be a way to the judge.
Judge? Always harping on the bloody old judge. We got a nice, respectable business now. Money coming in regular-like. And since we're careful to pick and choose, strangers, people who won't be missed, who's going to catch on?
Oh, Mr. Todd, I'm so happy. If I could eat you up, I really could. You know what I'd like to do, Mr. Todd? What I dream. If the business stays as good, where I'd really like to go. In a year or so. Don't you want to know?
Of course.
Do you really want to know?
Yes, I do.
By the sea, Mr. Todd, that's a life I carve it. By the sea, Mr. Todd, oh, I know you'd love it. You and me, Mr. T, we could be alone in a house where we'd almost own. Down by the sea.
Anything you say.
Wouldn't that be smashing? Think how snug it'll be underneath our flannel when it's just you and me and the English Channel. In our cosy retreat, kept all neat and tidy, we'll have jams over every Friday. By the sea, don't you love the weather? By the sea, we'll grow old together. Come by it, except a seagull. We shouldn't try it, though till it's legal for two. But a seaside wedding could be devised. Me rumble bedding legitimised. Me eyelids a flutter, or turn into butter. The moment I mutter, I do. Down by the sea, married nice and proper. By the sea, bring along your child.